I need you. I need you to hate. So I could use you for your energy. What's good, TTC, Trash Talking Circle? You know who it is. D1 Chosen, Fin Squad, Enforcer here. This vid is gonna, you know when your parents used to whoop your ass if you did something bad as a kid? I used to get my butt kicked. My daddy used to beat my ass with a belt. And my mama. And they would say that this will hurt me more than it will hurt you. It's gonna be one of those type of videos. The football trash talking circle. I am going to address a team that I have never bashed before on camera. I'm going to address a team to where I am an honorary member of. I am going to address a fan base I have never really addressed. I'm gonna address a quarterback I have never really addressed. So shit is about to go down. This may be a fucking classic. And I'm talking about the motherfucking Atlanta Falcons, as they call them. The Fail Clowns. A team that in the past 3 years hasn't been shit. I mean, a record of 4-12, 6-10, and 8-8. I mean, they only had one mediocre year, which is 8-8. Other than that, they've been basically below average to bottom dweller of a team in the last 3 years. I mean, these Falcons right now, I've seen that they have a lot of built-up hostility right now. Like, they really have a lot of built-up hostility, especially one Falcon fan in particular. You know, they really, and if I was them, I guess I'll be kind of salty too, but they not even salty. They've been salty for 3 years. They not even salty no more. They're sautéed. The sautéed Falcons fan base. Because I guess if I was in their situation the last 3 years, I'll be salty too. But thank God I have not been in the Falcons situation. Thank God I've been a Dolphin fan. I don't have to deal with the suck assness that the Falcons have had to deal with. I mean, just look at, we could just go to last year. They finished 8-8. That 8-8 wasn't like an 8-8 like the Dolphins has had the two seasons prior, where we've owned the wild card spot going into the last week of week 17 of the season. That was a true 8-8 record. You motherfucking Falcons fans actually wear this 8-8 record of last year as a badge of honor, like it was a legit 8-8. No, the fuck it wasn't. No, it's not. That is an ugly ass fat bitch, no tits, no ass type of motherfucking 8-8. Exactly what it looks like sideways, just like a fat bitch. You started off 5-0, beating the weak ass NFC East, and then beating the Saints, I believe, or whatever. Y'all started off 5-0, and you proceeded to go 3-8 for the rest of the season. Now y'all motherfuckers don't realize that. Like y'all went 3-8. You went a whole 6 weeks without winning a football game. But Matt Ryan the leader though. Matt Ryan is like a top 10 quarterback though. Like what is Matt Ryan? Huh? What? Last year, 2015, he went on a 6-game losing streak. He quarterbacked a team that had a month and a half losing streak after starting 5-0. But then it's gonna be like, but then the Tannehill would never start off 5-0. Yeah, but my quarterback would never lose 6 straight. The longest longest losing streak Tannehill's ever had was a 4-game losing streak, and that was during Bullygate. It took a national scandal for some shit from our quarterback to not be able to lead the team out of such a funk. But Matt Ryan is the shit, though. Like, 2014 season, what? You went on a 5-game losing streak. Once again, losing a month and a half worth of games. But where's Matt Ryan's leadership? Where's Matt Ryan's acumen of getting his team out of funk and putting some points on the board to win some games? The year before that, 2013, you go on a 5-game losing streak, going 4-12 for that season. I guess you bitches think that y'all going to win 2 extra games now. Since let's see, 2013, 4-12. 2014, 6-10. That's 2 games up. 2015, 8-8. That's another 2 games up. I guess y'all bitches think you going 10-6. No the fuck y'all ain't. Y'all have been horrible. You have been horrible the last 3 years in your fucking division. And you want to talk about how the Patriots or whatever whoop my ass. They've been dominated. You've been dominated by your division. 2013, you finished 1-5 in the NFC South. Which means Saints, Bucks, and the Saints, Bucks, and Panthers smacked you. Then y'all had that one good year, the fluke year, where y'all went 5-1 in the division, but then let a 7-8-1 team win the division. Like, that must suck. How do you go to 1-5 the season before your division, then 5-1, but then a 7-8-1 team win your division? Oh my God, I didn't realize how trash you bitches are. Y'all are beneath Dolphins. And then y'all go next year, also 2015 season, go right back to 1-5. Like, oh my God. Oh my God. Y'all mean, hold on, let's do the total. Y'all bitches is 7-11 the last 3 seasons in your division? 7-11? Y'all motherfuckers, what? Y'all must be, oh yeah, y'all motherfuckers 7-11. Y'all motherfucking, that defense stay getting open. That shit stay open. That's why motherfuckers stay slaying that defense. Y'all bitches complain about, oh, give Matt Ryan an O-line. Give Matt Ryan just a 15-ranked defense and watch he ball. What Matt Ryan have? Matt Ryan had the 4th-ranked O-line. For the first 11 weeks of the season, before Freeman went out with an injury, he led the league in rushing yards. Y'all had a ranked 15 defense, and Matt Ryan had his worst season to date. Like, oh my God. But then, motherfuckers gonna be like, but Tannehill ain't shit compared to Matt Ryan. Really? What has Matt Ryan done the last 3 seasons? Huh? That Tannehill hasn't done. Huh? Let me know. If I'm not mistaken, let's see. Ryan Tannehill has more wins than Matt Ryan has the last fucking 3 seasons. What else we want to total up? Then you want to talk about, but then these motherfucking Matt Ryan apologists. I'm going to call them Matt Ryan apologists. Because when I ask you what has Matt Ryan done in NFL lately, they want to throw me all these career stats. Shit that happened within the first 5 years of his career. That motherfucking them peaked out now. There is no more ceiling. We've seen Matt Ryan's ceiling. We've seen it. We've seen it already. It's already done. Gonzo. It's gonzo. It's funny how when your team had talent, Matt Ryan was doing really well as a quarterback. Now that your team is eroded of talent because y'all can't draft for shit, I don't know why motherfuckers keep picking up Patriots front office or coaches cast off and think they're going to do something. Demetri hasn't done shit for y'all since the Julio Jones trade. What have y'all done? 2013 draft class. Who y'all pick up? Who's doing something? What? Alford and Trufant? So you only got one out that draft? Everybody else is basically off your fucking team? Alford is borderline bust? Like, what have y'all done? What is your
front office done.
I know y'all motherfucking Saints fans and Panther fans and Bucks fans, y'all gonna eat this shit the fuck up. Cause this shit needs to be done. This shit, these motherfuckers really think that they actually have promise. Like their 8-8 season showed promise for the next year. What your draft class do in 2014? Let's think, what y'all do in 2014? What, y'all picked up Freeman? That's one viable starter. What, Jake Matthews? Borderline bust? Or you possibly getting better? Like, what have you done in your draft class lately? What y'all got last year? Vic Beasley? Huh? Like, what have y'all done? Honestly, what have y'all done? Especially compared to a Dolphin fan. What have y'all done since Tannehill been in the league? Now they're going to be like, but Tannehill was drafted 2012 and we went 13-3. But y'all remember those 13-3 records. I remember that shit. Because y'all had a lot of fourth quarter drives to win the game. The last time Matt Ryan actually looked like something. Because you know what, Falcon fans? Compared to Ryan Tannehill, let's see. In the last 3 years, Matt Ryan has 8 game-winning drives and 8 fourth-quarter comebacks. Tannehill has 6 game-winning drives and 8 fourth-quarter comebacks. That's damn near even with Matt Ryan. So let's compare. Now let's do touchdown-interception ratio to Matt Ryan and Ryan Tannehill. Let's see. Matt Ryan has, in the last 3 seasons, 75 touchdowns and 47 picks, to Ryan Tannehill's 76 touchdowns and 41 picks, which means in the last 3 years, Tannehill has 1 more touchdown than Matt Ryan and 6 less interceptions, and this is a motherfucker still trying to learn to play quarterback. He's still a wide receiver out there trying to play quarterback with one of the worst offensive lines in the league, but Matt Ryan is better. Get the fuck out of here, man. Y'all motherfucking Falcons, y'all motherfuckers really, really ain't shit. Like, I had to really take off my honorary Falcon fan goggles and see how truly trash y'all really are. Like, every part of your team. I mean, your O-line is finally getting up there. Your running backs is situated. Your fucking wide receiver core is fucking trash. And you know what's so funny? I was talking to a Falcons fan. I was like, yo, this is before they got Mohamed Sanu. I'm like, yo, your wide receiver core is trash. Roddy White, Devin Hester, Justin Hardy. All you have is the fucking all-world fucking Julio Jones. Other than that, your receiver core is trash. Then this motherfucker's going to try to spit knowledge to me like that's going to mean shit. Yo, motherfucker, Roddy White is washed up. Stop trying to make Devin Hester a wide receiver. Not working. I guess y'all don't believe in Justin and Justin Hardy since you want to pay Mohamed Sanu. What y'all signed him? 5 years, $32.5 million. Huh? That's $7 million a year? I guess y'all didn't believe him. And you know what's the funny? Do you know what's the funny thing, Falcon fans? That Roddy White had more receiving yards than Sanu! Like, y'all motherfuckers are stupid. Your whole front office is on some bogus shit right now. Like, god damn, y'all motherfuckers is on some bogus shit right now. So, you know, that's why I said saute Falcon. I'd be mad too if I was a Falcon fan. I'd really be mad too. I'd be mad that only in the past 2 seasons, my team has only mustered 41 sacks. In fucking 32 games, you only got 41 sacks. Like, oh my god, y'all hot trash. I had 41 sacks in just 2014 season alone. Y'all motherfuckers is no talented ass motherfucking team. Like, y'all got no D-linemen. And then here's the funny part. Is that these fucking Falcons organization, they let go of their best D lineman. Fucking Paul Soliai was ranked 14th of all DTs in the league. That's higher than anybody ranked on their D line, and they cut this motherfucker. They still gotta pay that niggas money next year. Still
gotta pay that Simone with that money next year too. Like, y'all motherfucker. Yo, man.
This fired Dimitrov. Fired Dimitrov. Like Dan Quinn, his first season was a failure. You don't start off 5-0 and then go 3-8 the rest of the season. Like y'all motherfuckers, like, what y'all gonna say? What's good, Sean Jay? What's good, bro? Huh? What's good, Joe Rock? I guess you ain't gonna respond to this because you're not in the TTC, so I guess I'll just see you in the comment section of this motherfucking classic roast of y'all motherfuckers. Y'all wanted to bring the Hawk out. You kept poking the bear. You wanted me to bring the motherfucking Hawk out. Huh, Saute? But they gonna be like, Matt Ryan's made the playoff. Matt Ryan's made the playoffs the last 3 years and that bitch is 1-4 in the playoff. Shut the fuck up. When the motherfucker was in the playoff 4 seasons ago.
And no, I'm not talking about the fucking restaurant.
Catch that bar, Sanjay. You like that one off the top. Like, y'all motherfuckers sauteed, yo. Y'all sauteed, motherfuckers. Y'all really sauteed. Like, I don't even know if I need to say anything else about y'all. I mean, y'all only beat, like three teams last year with a winning record, and those three teams was frauds. Besides, with all the only two of the three were frauds. You beat the motherfucking Texans and Redskins. Like two teams that I beat. Two teams that my Dolphins beat. like two teams my Dolphins beat. And then you played the Panthers and, of course, beat the Panthers, which was your quintessential win last year. If y'all didn't beat the Panthers, that's, y'all would have finished 7-9. Y'all would have been swept by everybody in your division. You better be happy y'all motherfuckers won that shit. Yo, oh my God, this is 16 minutes, all trash talk, no edit. This is what the TTC is, the Trash Talking Circle talking football. But I made this shit long enough. Y'all know who it is. D1 Chosen, Fin Squad, Enforcer here. I don't even think y'all could make it through all this. Too much flame. Too much.